So my research is interested in how core social and cognitive processing impacts wider area of functioning in atypical development. So that includes autism, Williams syndrome, children who have had adverse experiences. What I mean by core processes is really kind of things like face perception, social attention, self-concept, and wider areas of functioning. So that means that I kind of tie up with many different elements of psychology, so like forensic psychology, cyber psychology, educational psychology, and clinical psychology. A recent project we did was to look at how children with autism looked at faces and people within scenes when making decisions. So these could be social decisions about whether they would approach a group of youths or go into a shop if it was kind of had a big gang of youths standing outside. And basically we were interested in how they paid attention to the faces and people in those scenes when they were making these decisions on how to engage. And what we did find was that the autistic children looked less at the faces and people in these scenes and were more prone to making more risky decisions compared to their typical counterparts. So taking that forward, we'd be interested to see if this kind of, there is cross-syndrome overlap with kind of looking at faces, attending to people and making these decisions based on risk-taking or engaging with people, and really seeing if that kind of ties in any way with real-life vulnerability that they experience. Hopefully, with things like the kind of the social scenes and the risky decision making, that's going to be really crucial in understanding kind of real life vulnerability and our developmental disorders. Some of them are noted to be kind of at higher risk of being naive in certain situations and things like that. So taking that further, we would really like to get more students, more kind of funds and research assistants to kind of be working on trying to untangle cross syndrome vulnerabilities and how kind of social attention and eye gaze, face perception kind of feeds in or underpins those decision making strategies that they employ. For the social media one, we would be interested in again doing the same, trying to get some funding, trying to get some students to work on, again trying to look at cross syndrome use of online social media. Also, to find out if it truly is viewed to be a support, so maybe carry out some interviews with parents and with the autistic adolescents themselves and find out if they do view it as a good thing in their lives or if they are kind of experiencing any more risk in their everyday lives as well because of being online. So because my overarching theme really relates to core social and cognitive processes and wider implications of that, I'm quite open to either having PhDs that focus on the core cognitive or social processing. So if they wanted to do one face perception or social attention, self-concept, that'd be really good. Also, if they just wanted to focus on the wider functioning, so for example, the social media use in autism, or if they wanted one which is kind of looking at both and seeing whether these cognitive and social processes are underpinning these everyday functioning abilities, would be really good.